PS4 controller. The PS4 controller has screws, while the PlayStation 5 controller, you don't see no screws. That's another difference I noticed. I'm looking for the screws on the PlayStation 5 when I first got it, and noticed that there weren't no screws on there. So that was a huge difference I noticed. No screws at all on the PlayStation 5 controller. Small screws on the PlayStation 4. Which I'm assuming that's what makes it a wireless controller. The DualSense 5 is what they call it. Yeah, it don't have no screws at all. Not at all. That is the second major difference between these two controllers. And also, I want to mention, turn this back. You see, put the back a little bit long. Okay, you see these two by the side, you know, right? I especially like the edges of the controller on the PS5 and the PS4. It's like, even though it's built in, it's kind of give you more grip on the controller, which the PS4, I didn't feel that much of a grip down the bottom on the two sides right there. I feel like I got more of a grip with this controller, the PS5, than the PS4 controller right here. Much of a better, a whole lot better build. And also, I want to mention, I made a video last time talking about, as long as you have a laptop, you can play your PS4 or your PS5 controller on your PS4 system. In the middle right here where my finger's at, if you connect to your laptop, because I ain't got my laptop connected right now, you will see a white light appear or will appear on your controller. It's to let you know that you are connected between the laptop and the PS4 system. So that's how you will know if you are connected, because you will see a bright light in the middle there. So that's one thing to look for if you are trying to play your PS5 controller to your PS4 system. Look for a small white light in the middle of the controller. Let you know that it's connected. But yeah, I actually like how built it is compared to the PS4. And another benefit from PS5 controller to your PS4. If you playing, you know, I don't care what kind of game you playing. If you playing online and you happen to get some or play with someone who's in their connection is not 100%, and you start to have lag in the game. Y'all know what I'm talking about when it be lagging in the game sometimes. At least with the PS5 controller, you will have a fighting chance to deal with that better. Unlike the PS4, which it's just gonna mess you up completely. It's just gonna mess you up completely. At least with this controller, if you're playing this controller on your PS4 system, you have more better control, I want to say, with it. So that's another benefit for playing the PS5 controller on your PS4. When it starts getting lag, you have more of a better control of a better situation, I would say. You can deal with it. You can deal with it much more better with this controller compared to the PS4 controller. Those are just automatic dips I noticed between these two controllers. Yeah, and I just gotta wonder with the PS5 controller, the way it's built, the way it's made in general. I'm kind of curious if they ever come out with a PlayStation 6, which most likely will. It's like they bring a new gaming system every few months. They don't allow their last system a whole year to be out before they start making noise. But I'm gonna talk about that another time. It seems like PlayStation 5 is already here when PlayStation 4 had really been out that long. So like I said, that's a conversation for another time. But this one, I just was kind of curious. This is the route they're going with these PlayStation controllers, and this is how they're making them now. I was kind of wondering what kind of changes we may see if they ever come out with a PlayStation 6. Because the change I'm seeing in the PlayStation 5 controller, I'm actually liking so far. I have nothing negative at all to say. This controller actually functions real well with my PS4. Well, let's be honest. For me personally, this PlayStation 5 controller is functioning with my PS4 than my actual PS4 controller. Okay. But I see a lot of those are some benefits I actually noticed when playing my PS4 system with my PS5 controller. Now the reason I still keep my PS4 controller around, even though I have this, because they are certain things I cannot do with the PS5 controller on my PS4 system. I have to have my PS4 system for those certain things. But other than that, I give a PS5 control system a thumbs up. I have yet to run into a real problem yet with this new home controller. It actually works really well. Really well. Yeah, those are just my thoughts. The major difference I noticed immediately after having this PlayStation 5 controller for a while compared to the PlayStation 4. So, leave me a comment. Let me know if anything you notice different between playing with this controller than the actual PS4 controller on your PS4 system. If you like the video, thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you soon.